वसतु मा सद्गमय तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय मृत्युर्मा अमृतं गमय।
हेलो चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू मल्लारेड्डी मेमोरियल स्कूल डिजिटल क्लासेस। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड लोकेशन ऑफ पेनिगोलु विलेज। इट इज़ ऑन द हिल्स एंड आल्सो इन वाजीडु मंडल। इन दिस वीडियो लेट अस डिस्कस द फार्मिंग इन पेनिगोलु विलेज। देर इज़ ए डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ फार्मिंग वी कैन सी इन पेनिगोलु विलेज, दैट इज पोडु। कोयास ग्रो क्रॉप्स यूजिंग ए सेपरेट टेक्निक कॉल्ड पोडु। पोडु इज अ ट्रेडिशनल प्रैक्टिस ऑफ फार्मिंग इन हिली एरियाज और इन हिली रीजियंस। पोडु इज ए ट्रेडिशनल प्रैक्टिस ऑफ फार्मिंग। दिस इज कॉल्ड शिफ्टिंग एग्रीकल्चर or zoom cultivation. Podu is also called shifting agriculture or zoom cultivation. Podu is also practiced by tribes like Kondareddy. In the previous video we have discussed that the different types of tribal communities. Okay, so Kondareddy is a one of the different types of tribal community. So these Kondareddy tribes also practiced podu agriculture. This practice of shifting cultivation is also done in states like Andhra Pradesh, Chhattisgarh and Arunachal Pradesh. Let us see how the podu agriculture has done. Each village has a specified area or hill that they can use for farming. Each village in hills has a separate or specified area or hill that they can use for farming. Within this area, people clear a patch of forest and burn it. Then they grow crops on these fields for a few years. After that, they leave that patch of land and allow the forest to grow. Meanwhile, they move to another site in that area where they clear another patch of forest land to grow crops for a few years. This way, their farms keep shifting every few years and they return to these plots after many years. In the hills, it stops raining around November month. The Koyas then use their axes to clear patches of forest in the month of December. In the month of December, the Koyas cut the forest and clear the land. They remain the logs of woods and dry on the fields for a few months. When they cut the forest, they remain the logs of woods and dry on the fields for a few months. Then they burnt these logs of woods in April or May, just before rains. Okay, when the rain comes, they burn it in the month of April and May. People sow seeds with the help of digging sticks. Children, in the picture you can see the sticks that the man carried. These sticks are called digging sticks. They sow with the help of these digging sticks. This way, they sow seeds of many crops together by broadcast method. Broadcast method means spreading the seeds on the ground. Okay, you can see a man is spreading seeds on the ground. This method is called broadcast method. They do not use plow or hoe and any fertilizers. One of the reasons for not using plow on the hill slopes is that this would loosen the soil too much. When we use plow, hoe or fertilizers, that will loosen the soil too much. That's why they don't use plow, hoe or fertilizers. This would lead to easy wash away of the topsoil during the rains. Now, when we use a plow or hoe or fertilizers, they easily loosen the soil, and that soil will be washed away during the rains. That's why they don't use it. This would make the fields infertile. Yeah, when the topsoil is washed away with the rains, the field which is remained is infertile. Okay, if the field is infertile, we cannot grow crops on it. The topsoil is the most fertile of the fields. Yeah, generally we can see the topsoil is the most fertile on the field. Farmers want the ashes and dead leaves to remain on the land. Farmers don't want ash and leaves washed away. Farmers, they remain the ashes and leaves on the land, and they don't want to wash away these leaves and ashes, because these ashes and leaves makes the land fertile. That's why they don't want to wash away these ash and leaves. Children, this is all about the podu agriculture. We can discuss about the crops that grow in this hilly region in our next video. Thank you, children. Have a nice day.